I'm Mattis Icker. I'm a marine scientist working for the ocean cleanup, and I'm studying ocean plastic pollution. My research focuses primarily on the question how much plastic there is in the ocean and where does it eventually end up. So how much is floating at the surface and how much is in the end sinking to the seabed. Usually it is very difficult to get data from remote regions such as the ocean garbage patches here in the North Pacific Ocean, for example. And so what's really unique here is that we have a vessel that is staying in these garbage patches for a longer time, let's say over a few weeks. And this really provides a great opportunity to collect data not only just on one day, but actually over a longer time period. It looks so pristine if you just have the first glance at the ocean, but the longer you look, the more you see just so much trash floating around. And on a calm day, you can see clouds of microplastics in the water. So it's not an island, but it's a plastic soup. And because it is a soup and the plastic debris is so dispersed here, that's exactly why we need a cleanup system. We need somehow a method or a technology that can first accumulate the plastic and concentrate it into a smaller surface area before we can actually efficiently extract the plastic from the ocean.
It's huge, and this is what the garbage patch is like made of. Half of it is marine-based sources of debris, and that's how it looks like. Big.
In ocean plastic research, there's this big gap of the amount of plastic that we think is going into the ocean and the amount of plastic that we're finding back. So in the past, the ocean cleanup has performed some measurements in the vertical distribution of plastic to see how much is actually at the surface and then how it decreases with depth. But this study has focused on the top 5 meters of the water column. And what we're doing now is we go a step further. So we actually, instead of just focusing on the top 5 meters, we actually go all the way down to 2,000 meters. Also, in terms of fluxes, what is the flux of plastic from the ocean surface to the deep sea? And there's simply no data on that collected so far. And that's what we are aiming with this mission, to fill this gap, to go deeper and to dive into the ocean and to try to get a more complete picture of plastic pollution out here.
So we just deployed two kind of equipment. One is to characterize the water column, measuring salinity, temperature, density, and the other one is a pump. We use this pump to sample microplastics to see like how deep do we find microplastics. Is it down there in the deep sea? And how does it actually reach the deep sea? That's what we're interested in.
It is somewhat very depressing to see it firsthand. On the other hand, it's also, and that's also why I joined the ocean cleanup, it motivates me to see that we're actually doing something against it. We're trying to clean it up, we're trying to understand exactly how these patches form, how long they persist, and so it's good to be out here, yeah.